We're here at SHOT Show 2011 with Bryan Litz of Berger Bullets. Bryan is one of Berger's bullet designers and a top shooter in his own right. Bryan, tell us about the new offerings Berger has for this year.
The most exciting thing that we're doing right now with bullet design and new bullets is the hybrid. The hybrid bullet is a combination of ogives between secant and tangent. In other words, it takes the best aspects of a tangent ogive bullet, which is length tolerance, and combines it with the low drag of a VLD bullet. So what you have is essentially low drag, like a VLD bullet, and a bullet that's easy to load for accuracy and doesn't require extensive tuning.
Can you really just put the two design concepts together? Isn't it sort of like trying to blend a drag racer with a school bus?
There's uses for drag racing school buses, actually, if you know how to put them together. The portion of the ogive that's tangent is only the portion that engages the riflings. That's the only part that has to do with the mechanical centering of the bullet in the bore. Once beyond that portion of the ogive, it transitions to secant because it doesn't contact the barrel. So you take the exact attribute that makes the tangent ogive good at precision and combine it with the attribute that makes a VLD good at having low drag, and yeah, you can put them together into one bullet.
Now, there's been good feedback on the 7mm hybrids. Are you modifying or updating the design to any respect based on the feedback?
Not really. It worked really well in 7mm, and the 338-300 grain bullet is also a hybrid ogive, and both of those calibers, both of those hybrid ogives have worked very good. So we're going to extrapolate that, starting with 30 caliber, and we're going to take it down into lower calibers as time goes on. But I guess we'll learn as we go, but we know now that between 7mm and 338 that the design concept works well.
Now, what about the loading manual? Is that in the works?
Oh yeah, the loading manual is nearing completion. We have printed rough drafts of it here, and they contain most of the text and part of the data that will be in it. So we have the foundation in place, and it's just a matter of a couple more months to finish the work that goes into it, and then we'll go to print.
Availability. Are all the popular bullets in stock, being shipped across the country, or do you have any supply issues?
We have been experiencing supply challenges. That is our highest priority to resolve. We're at about 75% fill rate right now, and a lot of discussion between our team at the show has been about achieving 100% fill rate as a priority before we work on more new innovative designs. I mean, parallel to, but the fill ratio is an extremely important part of what we're doing now.
Now, what about pricing? The biggest complaint I'm hearing from my readers is, man, bullets are getting really expensive now. Is Berger working to kind of hold the line on costs?
I'm not the right person really to ask that question. I don't deal with pricing. I know that the cost of our bullets is related to the raw materials, which fluctuates in price, and the speed of the process. Our process is one that produces high precision bullets, and like any other process that has high standards and close tolerances, it's a slower process than one that produces less expensive bullets.
Hey, I got a tip for you. Lapua's new bullet, they're putting a little crest on the heel of the bullet. Are we going to see Berger bullets with a little B imprinted on the bottom of the bullets?
No.
All right, Bryan, any other new stuff for 2011?
There is a 175 grain tactical bullet that will become part of our line. The tactical bullet is, what makes it a tactical bullet is that it's magazine length feedable, which is not a property of most of our bullets. Most of our bullets are too long to feed through magazine, but this 175, it's got a good BC, but not a great BC because the nose isn't obviously that long. So it's designed to work in the systems that require magazine length feeding.
Great. Thanks a lot, Bryan. Appreciate it.
You bet.